Building backlinks is a pain. Wouldn't it be great if there was an easier way to build links? Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm going to break down a new way to build links. Now before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. So the first thing I want you to do is go to neilpatel.com/backlinks. And or you can just Google Backlink Checker, Neil Patel, and you'll see it. And when you go to this page, I want you to put in your own URL. So I'm going to put in neilpatel.com. And it takes me to Ubersuggest. It takes me to the Backlinks report where I can see how many links I have. But then what I want you to do is go to this new report, which is the Backlink Opportunity report. So I'm going to put in neilpatel.com. And I'm going to select domain. It's already selected. Then I'm going to put in a few of my competitors like moz.com and click the plus button. I'm going to put in maybe search engine land. Click the plus button. Maybe even search engine journal.com. Click the plus button. So what this report does before I click search, it shows you all the people who link to your competitors and don't link to you. The reason this is important is if you go out there and you do a ton of outreach, and let's say you hit up a ton of websites out there on the web and you just try to get links. Well, if most of those websites don't link to anyone in your space, you or your competition, what do you think the chances are that they're going to link to you? Slim to none. But on the flip side, if there's hundreds, if not thousands of websites that link to tons of your competitors, even two or three of them, what's the chances that they'll link to you? Very high. For example, if Mozilla here links to Moz, Search Engine Journal, and Search Engine Land, there's a good chance if I do outreach to them, I can probably get them to link back to me. Not always, but some cases. And you can see what URL specifically, when you click the dropdown, link to your competitors. And I can see it here with this line.me, and I can just keep going down. This one's t.me. I think that's Twitter URL shortener. I could be wrong on that one. Here's w3.org. Good opportunities there. Here's one, Wikimedia, a lot of good opportunities there. Yahoo, would love a link from there. But that's the overall point, right? If you see a lot of people linking to your competition, you can typically get them to link to you as well. And you can actually base it off of a specific URL as well. Like this URL here links to three of my competitors. This URL here links to three of my competitors. And you can do that, and by looking at the specific URLs, you'll be like, all right, if someone's linking to multiple of my competitors, like this Amazon affiliate page, I have tons of articles on affiliate marketing that I could probably hit up Amazon and be like, hey, would you be interested in linking to me as well? This strategy is one of the easiest ways to build links. Now, when you go to one of these sites and you're trying to build links, like let's say I go to, I don't know, I'm going to end up pulling, you know, w3.org, right? And in a new tab, it's pulling W3, and it's a slideshow presentation. I'm going to go back to view, show URLs, show toolbar. All right. So, you know, if I'm like, all right, I want W3 to link out to me, you can use a cool site called hunter.io, which is free, and you can like type in any domain name. You just have to register. It'll tell you they found tons of people's email addresses and they'll give them to you. All you have to do is just click find. But you can end up getting a lot of emails for free every month, 25 searches. So that's great. And I would just go through this and I would start finding more and more emails. And what's really cool with this strategy is you can get super specific. And here's an example for this. So I'm going to type in the keyword SEO. As you can see, I rank on page one in the United States, but I don't rank number one. I only rank on page one. Moz ranks ahead of me, so I'm going to end up loading up that email or URL. Here's one from Search Engine Land. Here's one from Wikipedia. And then you got the one from neilpatel.com. So if you look at this article, it's on an introduction to SEO beginner's guide, right? This one is introduction to SEO as well, like what is SEO, how does it work? This one's similar, search engine optimization, what it is, the definition, the history. Mine, intro as well. So they're all very similar. So now what I want you to do is you take your URL. So I'm going to take mine and I'm going to pop it here. So put in, enter your domain or URL. Change the type from domain to URL so you can see exactly who's linking to your URL. And then I would do the same for my competition. So then I'm going to go to this Moz one. Let me click the X's here. And I'm going to end up putting URL. So I want to see the Moz URL and who links to them, but who doesn't link to me. I'll do the same with Search Engine Journal. Make sure you select URL. Then I'm going to end up clicking on the Wikipedia one. And that's it. So when I click and run this report, it's going to do a search to see who's linking to my competition, but not me. Again, if a website or multiple websites link to competitor articles that are very similar, like theirs is all about the introduction to SEO or what is SEO, and they don't link to me, this is great. Like, I look here. All right. This developer.apple.com/SwiftBlog links to the Wikipedia and the Moz Beginner Guide. iTunes links to both of them as well. Google support, you know, and it keeps going on and on and on. And this is showing me who's linking all to my competition, but not me. This one links to both Search Engine Land, Moz, Wikipedia. This is a great one. And this article is... I'm going to load it up here. How to scale your content and marketing for international traffic, right? This article no longer exists. I'm going to scroll down a little bit more. W3, right? So I can go hit up this, the person who wrote this one, and try to hit someone up at the W3 website, try to get them to add a link also to my website. Let's see, and I'm going to keep scrolling, looking for more options. Here's one on ISSUU blog, top publishing trends of 2020. I can hit them up as well, try to get them to link to me. And as I go through this, you know, you can keep going through and you'll find a lot of people linked to your competition, but not you. But the reason I like using this one and going back up, this one gives you specific people who are linking to a specific article, not just a domain, but an article. So if you have multiple players linking to a competitor's article and it's very similar to yours, but yours is more in-depth and more updated, you can outreach to them. Like I may say, hey, John, I noticed you linked to Moz and Search Engine Land and Wikipedia when it comes to, you know, an overview on SEO. But you know what? AI and SEO is a really booming topic, and none of them really cover that. But when you go to all the conferences, everyone's talking about that. Check out this article, and not only take breaks down the, you know, introduction and the basics SEO, but it also breaks down how people can leverage SEO AI to use that to increase their rankings over time. I think your readers will love it. Cheers, Neil. And when you do stuff like that, you'll get more targeted links. And the overall goal is, if you're emailing out 100 people and you're getting very specific, very customized with your email, you're using these strategies, you should aim for 15 plus links. It's super, super effective. It's a great way to increase your rankings. If you have any questions on how you can leverage this tactic, or if you're confused in any way, leave a comment below. I'm here to help you out. If you just want my agency to do everything for you, check out NP Digital. I hope you like the video, share it, tell the people about it. Thank you for watching.